Hello there! In this video, I'd like to give you an overview of how to set up a project for the SIG Safe EV Pro system in the Configuration Software Safety Designer. All you need is the latest version of Safety Designer software, downloadable on SIG.com, and the EV Pro components you would like to configure. So let's get started. On the starting page, you can choose between creating a new offline project, search for devices that are connected to your PC, or open an offline project that was previously created. Also note that your last saved projects are listed below. In our example, we create a new offline project. In order to create a new project, let's first set a name for it. For our current purposes, it is okay to just name it Tutorial. In the tab Network, we have to set the IP range, the subnet mask, and also the router address. Here you can choose whether every new device gets automatically an IP address in the defined range. Next, we have to set the safety network number. The safety network number has to be the same for all participants in the safety network. We can either generate a new one or just use the one that is automatically generated. Use this box to choose whether the safety network number should be assigned to all EV Pro participants or not. The next step is to configure the devices. In the heading Configuration, we can add devices. In our example, we need a FlexiSoft. We can easily add it via drag and drop. We could also use a simple double click to do that. If we apply the FlexiSoft, the device window opens automatically. The first tab offers a general overview, like for example the device information, the connection or the system status. In the next tab, we can find the previously defined settings, such as the IP addresses or the safety network number. Also, the hardware can be configured in here. The right side shows the device catalog. Here, we can add modules or elements, such as the Safe EV Pro Gateway. In most cases, you also need an I/O module, like for example an XTIO. For the moment, let's just focus on the connection of the gateway in this video. After adding the gateway, a new chapter appears in the navigation bar on the left. In the device identification of the gateway, the safety network number will be adopted from our project settings before. In the next chapter, network settings, the IP address has also been pre-selected and is in accordance with the range that we have defined before. And this is all for the FlexiSoft. Let's get started with the MicroScan 3 EFI Pro. We go back to our main window and add a MicroScan 3 EFI Pro to our devices. Just as before, we can easily add it by drag and drop or with a double click. We now want to configure the MicroScan 3 EFI Pro using the selection wizard. To do that, just double click on the scanner. The selection wizard opens, and in our example, we will configure a MicroScan 3 EFI Pro with a maximum protective field range of 9 meters and Pro functionality. Note the tick box that allows us to directly enter the device configuration when clicking on Apply. Under the tab Configuration, all necessary settings can be set, like for example the IP address, which has been adopted from the previously defined project information. In the tab Identification, we can verify the safety network number. So everything is prepared for our connection of the FlexiSoft to the laser scanner via EFI Pro. We go back to our main window. In the chapter Connection, we can track the line from the FlexiSoft to the laser scanner. After that, our devices are connected successfully. Now you have all necessary settings for the connection between the FlexiSoft and the MicroScan 3 via EFI Pro.